Hey, Freddy with CJ Pony Parts. When shopping for aftermarket wheels, two common measurements that you're going to come across that a lot of people get confused by are offset and backspacing. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to find offset and backspacing and also help you understand what they are. In this video, we're going to be working with this TSW Bathurst wheel. It measures 18 by 8 inches and has 40 millimeters of offset and 6.07 inches of backspacing. I'm going to start off by showing you how to find the true width of the wheel. If you recall earlier, I said this is an 18 by 8 wheel, which means it's 8 inches wide, but not the actual width of the wheel. The 8 inches means from bead to bead. This is for the tire. If you actually measure the width of the actual wheel, you'll get 9 inches, which is not right. To find that 8 inches, you measure from the bead to the bead. And that is 8 inches. If you're shopping for wheels, or if you have a set of wheels laying around and you want to find the true width of them, you're not going to measure from the outside to the outside. You measure from the bead to the bead, and that is the true width of the wheel. Now that you know what width is, we're going to talk about offset. Offset of the wheel is the relationship of the face of the hub to the center line of the wheel. So imagine if this line right here is the center of the wheel. Zero offset would mean the face of the hub on the inside of the wheel is dead center in the wheel. If the face of the hub moves towards the front of the wheel, that's positive offset. If the face of the hub moves towards the rear of the wheel or the inside, that is negative offset. In the case of this wheel has 40 millimeters of positive offset, which means it's 40 millimeters towards the front of the wheel. So we know what offset is. Now we're going to talk about backspacing. Backspacing is the amount of wheel that sticks out past the face of the hub. Since this wheel is 8 inches wide, it has 40 millimeters of offset, or an inch and a half of offset, so it's going to have 6 inches of backspacing. There's 6 inches of wheel from the face of this hub sticking out. Now that we know what backspacing and offset is, I'm going to show you how to find them. To find the offset, you're going to want to put the wheel on a flat surface and then measure to the surface that it touches. We're using this cardboard because it's completely flat and it goes right across the top of the wheel, giving us a nice flat line. We're now going to measure from this cardboard down to the table that the wheel is sitting on. And as you'll see, it is exactly 9 inches. Now, we don't need the true width of the wheel for this. Like I stated earlier, it doesn't need to be 8 inches. But this measurement is from the bottom of the wheel to the top of the wheel, and this is 9 inches. So write that down, 9 inches. So now that we know the actual width of the wheel is 9 inches, as you can see right here, you're gonna need to find the center of the wheel to find the offset. So just simply divide this number in half. So half of 9 is 4.5. So the very center of this wheel is at 4.5 inches. For this part, we're going to measure from the face of the hub to the top of the wheel. So from the face of the hub to the top of the wheel, you can see it is exactly 6 inches. So 6 inches from the face of the hub to here is 6 inches of backspacing. So now we're going to find how much offset this wheel actually has. We got our measurement of 9 inches wide. That is the width of the entire wheel. And then we divided that number in half to find the center line, and that's 4.5 inches in the very center. And then we found out we had 6 inches of backspacing, and the very center of the wheel is 4.5 inches. So 6 minus 4.5 gives us 1.5 inches, or 40 millimeters. So now, the hub is right here. And so now, since this is further towards the front of the wheel, it's positive offset. So we have 1.5 inches, or 40 millimeters of offset. If this were the opposite direction though, if the hub was back here, it would be negative offset. So now that we know how to find offset and backspacing, what are the practical uses? Why do you even need to know those numbers? How's it going to help you at all? Well, we'll talk about offset for right now. Now, with offset, With a positive offset, you'll get more of a flush, flatter look, just like this wheel. It's got positive offset, so the hub is closer to the front. And as you can see, the spokes have a very slight dish, but overall, it's kind of flat, actually. If you want more of a lip on your wheel or a dished or bold look, you're gonna move the hub back, so you're gonna get negative offset. It's gonna take the hub back, and everything's gonna go in. Offset can also affect how much wheel sticks out past your fender or how much wheel doesn't stick out past your fender. In this case, this wheel also has 40 millimeters of positive offset, so that means the hub is just a little bit further from the center, out towards the car, which means not much of the rim is sticking out. If the wheel had a lot of negative offset, if the hub was further back in, more of the barrel would be sticking out and it would come out past the fenders. The more positive offset you have, the further the wheel is going to be in from the fender. The more negative offset you have, the further this wheel is going to stick out. We have the car up in the air now so we can show you exactly what backspacing is. Backspacing is super important, especially if you're going to get wider wheels, and I will show you why. This wheel has 6.5 inches of backspacing, and when I turn the wheel, watch how close it comes to hitting right here. That comes within about maybe 3/4 of an inch, maybe even 1/2 inch to almost hitting right here. So like I said, this wheel has 6.5 inches of backspacing, and as you saw, it came within about 1/2 inch, maybe 3/4 of an inch to having contact right here. So if you either got a wider wheel or changed the offset to where you had more than 6.5 inches of backspacing, maybe 7, even 7.5, you'd probably run into clearance issues, which is not good. So when shopping for wheels, make sure you know how much offset you can have or how much offset you want. So in this case, 6.5 inches of backspacing on this wheel is absolutely perfect. If you wanted to run any more backspacing, you're probably gonna run into clearance issues. So when shopping for wheels, make sure you know how much backspacing you can run, and hopefully this helps you out. So I've showed you what offset and backspacing is and also how to find it. Now all that's left is for you to go out and get some awesome wheels. We have tons available at cjponyparts.com, and I'll see you next time.